Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's our second video on solving quadratic equations by factorising. Let's start by linking to something we already know. Pause the video and each of the three cases please find x or solve for x. Well, by these first two in particular, you can just spot x. Something add 7 is going to equal 0. X must be negative 7, right? Negative 7 add positive 7, 0. 7 take away what gives you 0? Well, 7 take away 7. X must be 7 here. Now, in this case, it might just require a tiny bit of thinking. You know, in the I'm thinking of an X forming expressions, we had X, we added 7, and we got X add 7, and then we multiplied the answer by 2, and we got 2 brackets X add 7. So to go backwards, the first thing we do is divide both sides by 2. And that would give us X add 7 is equal to 0 divided by 2 is just 0, and therefore x must be equal to negative 7. So in these cases here, you don't really have to do that much work, because what you can do is you can divide both sides by 2 in your head, and you just get left with x add 7 is 0, so therefore x must be negative 7. It's the same as this case here. You get the same answer here and here. So I'm going to need you good at this skill for this particular video. And this is the type of thing we've already done. We have solved quadratics of the following form. So just pause the video for a second and double check you remember how to solve a quadratic like that. Step one, hope you remember, is you factorise it. You're looking for two numbers that multiply to positive 30, add to positive 11, x add 5, x add 6 do the trick. Don't forget they equal 0. Two things multiplying to give 0. You know that either the first thing must be 0, x add 5 is 0, or the other option is the second expression is equal to 0. In this case, therefore, subtracting 5 off both sides, x is negative 5. In this case here, subtracting 6 off both sides, x is negative 6, and we have ourselves two potential answers. So I need you also really on top of this, so make sure you've watched Solving Quadratics Equations 1 by factorising before you even attempt this skill. And this is the type of example we're going to do in this video. If you feel like you can do it, pause and go ahead. If not, wait with me and go through it with me. What's different here? There is a number other than 1 in front of x squared. The coefficient of x squared is 2. But these are the simple cases. This is the case where just before you launch into trying factorizing this, you just think, 2 is a factor of 2, 10, and 12. So I can factor out the 2 and I'd get x squared add 5x add 6 is equal to 0. Then I can factorise the quadratic expression here and I would get x add 2, x add 3, and that is equal to 0. Now we've got three things multiplying to give you 0. Now 2 is just 2, okay? That is fixed, all right? It's either this number's got to be 0 or this number's got to be 0 in order to get 0 as an answer overall. That can't be 0 because it's 2, right? So you don't have to worry about that anymore. You say your two potential answers are therefore, as before, x add 2 is 0 or x add 3 is equal to 0. Subtracting 2 off both sides, you get x is either negative 2 as an answer, subtracting 3 off both sides, or x is negative 3. Underline your answers. There you go. Very like before, other than you've just had to factorise out a number at the start. Pause and definitely try this one yourself. Right, I would have factorised out a 3 and got x squared add 11x add 30 is equal to 0. Then I would have kept that 3 there and tried to factorise the bracket, which I would have got x add 5, x add 6 is equal to 0. I know either this thing or this thing must be 0 for 3 times that to be 0. So either x add 5 equals 0 or x add 6 is 0. They're the only options. Subtracting 5 from both sides, x is negative 5 is one answer. Subtracting 6 off both sides, x is negative 6 is the other potential answer. And there we go, done. Okay, let's have a look at some more. These ones have negative 1 or negative coefficient of x squared. If you feel confident, please go ahead and try. Otherwise, I'm going to go through now. I showed you these previously when factorising these type of things. So step one, factorise as normal. factorise out a negative 1 in this case because of that negative. That makes everything a lot easier. So factorise out a negative 1 and we'd get x squared add 8x add 12 is equal to 0. Keep that negative 1 there. Factorise the quadratic expression. We'd get ourselves x add 2, x add 6 is equal to 0. Now I've got a number times another expression is 0. The only way this thing can be 0 is either this expression 0 or this one. The negative 1 doesn't make a difference. So either we have x add 2 is equal to 0 or x add 6 is equal to 0. If we subtract 2 off both sides, we get x is negative 2 is one answer. And if we subtract 6 off both sides, we get x is negative 6 is the other. Now you should definitely be ready for this one. Pause and have a go if you didn't try that one. Well, I'm going to factorise out a negative and a 4 here. And when I do that, I'd get myself x squared add 2x take away 15 is equal to 0. Why? Negative 4 times x squared is negative 4x squared. Negative 4 times positive 2x is negative 8x. Negative 4 times negative 15 is positive 60. So when I factorise out a negative, things that were negative become positive. Things that were positive become negative. And keep that negative 4 there. Factorise the quadratic expression here. This would be equal to x add 5, x subtract 3 is equal to 0. Therefore, either this expression, x add 5, is equal to 0, or the other option is x subtract 3 is equal to 0. Taking away 5 from both sides, x is negative 5 is one solution, or if you add 3 to both sides, x is going to be positive 3 is the other solution. And let's finish with one more example. Please try this one yourself at this stage in the video. So here we've got a negative x squared. Think of that as negative 1 lot of x squared. When you see that, as I've said before, start off by step 1, factorising out negative 1. And what would you get? Well, you'd get x squared add 8x subtract 20 is equal to 0. Why again? Well, when we're factorising out the negative 1, anything negative becomes positive, and anything already positive now becomes negative. And if you times it back out, trust me, you get the same thing. I've just also rearranged the x squareds to come first, the x's to come second, and the number to go last. Anyway, same old process now. Keep that negative 1 there. Factorise this quadratic expression. Two numbers that multiply to negative 20 and add to positive 8. What's that going to be? Well, I make that x add 10, x subtract 2 is equal to 0. Now, the negative 1 is fixed. In order for these three things to multiply to 0, either x add 10 is 0 or x subtract 2 is 0. So there are only two options, so write them down. Taking away 10 from both sides, x is negative 10 is one potential solution. Adding 2 to both sides, x is positive 2 is the other. And we're done. And that's it for this particular video. Thanks for watching.